we put it on our GPS.
Lots of turns.
But you're coming on these dirt rocky roads and you're kind of like, wait a minute.
So I live right down the hill.
We didn't see any buildings.
Everybody says this is the middle of nowhere, but it's the middle of something, actually.
Cut.
Every week, dozens, if not hundreds, of beer lovers make the pilgrimage to Greensboro, Vermont, in search of Hill Farmstead Brewery. The retail shop opens at noon, and it's not uncommon to see a line form well before that.
I always figured some people would come here to buy beer. People travel around the world and try to visit as many breweries as possible. Beer tourism is nothing new, it's no secret. But I never expected that, you know, that we'd have 50 cars and 100 people waiting in line at the point that we opened. There's 26 bottles left. If you want one.
An
Everett? Do you like porter?
Shaun Hill opened Hill Farmstead in 2010, and by 2013 received the honors of Best Brewer in the World by RateBeer.com. Since then, the lines outside his brewery have been filled with visitors from all over the country.
We're both from Bergen County. I'm from Allendale, New Jersey.
Fairlawn, New Jersey.
And we came up for beer. I mean, that's what you come up for.
I'm from Buffalo, New York, and I'm here for the beer, to be perfectly honest with you.
I live in Boston now, and I'm actually bringing a few back for my bosses and some other coworkers who are big fans.
And it's well worth the drive, no matter how long it takes, no matter how long you have to wait in line to get it. It's well worth it.
Thank you.
This is the only place you can buy Hill Farmstead beer and take it home and drink it. So in other words, we do send beer out into the market, but it only goes to restaurants and bars that pour it on tap.
We'll test the pH and the gravity again at the end of the boil.
What seems like an overnight success has actually been more than 18 years in the making.
I started homebrewing when I was 15, high school science fair project. Started a homebrew club in college and made beer, and then in 2002-03 in the mornings I was teaching at a private school on the mountain road in Stowe, and then in the afternoons I was washing kegs and cleaning tanks at the Shed Brewery. Became the head brewer there in the spring of 2005, and then worked at Trout River for a year, all the while trying to find a place to try to start the brewery or start a brand, which would have been called Grassroots Brewing. I tried to do that in Hardwick, but it didn't work out.
Whenever possible, Shaun traveled to Europe to experience other brewing techniques. And before starting Hill Farmstead, he spent 2 years working with renowned brewmaster Anders Kissmeyer in Denmark.
You can see that it hangs on the glass like port wine does. That is, we're making a very dark beer today.
Hill Farmstead makes a wide variety of beer, but it's also become well known for creative collaborative brews. During a visit in July, Mullen Olivier from Holland, along with brewers from Norway, were working on a new collaboration with Shaun.
I tried to sort of stick to a set of principles that we would only do collaborations with people that we knew and that sort of helped form Hill Farmstead prior to its existence. So when we started Hill Farmstead, the fourth beer brewed at the brewery was a collaboration with that former boss of mine, Anders Kissmeyer. We brewed that beer, named it Fear and Trembling, after a Søren Kierkegaard work of philosophy.
Well, I know Shaun for a while. He was a brewer in Denmark for a while, and we met there years ago. And then sort of when you are good at brewing, you meet, you talk, and what you do is you learn from each other, you know. And when you build a recipe, you just mail back and forth over how is this going to be a good beer. And but Shaun has a very good reputation, so we'll end up having a fine beer.
Good job, Adam.
Good job, Shaun. Not me. I have to sit and watch.
In addition to the popular collaborations, Hill Farmstead has also created a real buzz around its annual public events.
We try to do two events a year. One Memorial Day weekend, which is our anniversary party. It's also my birthday. We try to sort of save back kegs of all of our best releases. Usually we'll do between 350 and 500 people. People camp. We try to put together some good performances, music, and sort of just set it up in a creative way. And then we do another one in August called the Festival Farmhouse Ales. We really try to give an authentic Hill Farmstead experience at those events. I'm not sure exactly what an authentic Hill Farmstead experience is, but that's what it is. That's what we're trying to do. Florence is all European hops, lots of Styrian Golding. Edward has lots of Simcoe and other Pacific Northwest varietals.
Names brings everything to a beer, a lot of character.
This is Edward, it's a pale ale, nice and hoppy.
This is Florence.
Society and Solitude.
We had actually all of them, all four. Edward, Florence, Society, and Destruction, whatever it's called, and then the Grassroots.
Most of the beers are either named after Hill's ancestors or come from a favorite philosophical work. A list of all the beer names can be found on their website.
We have a lot of people walk through the door who say that they don't like hoppy beer or they don't like IPAs because they're too bitter and there's something about them that is maybe repulsive to their palate. But we go to great lengths to make sure that the beer is soft and palatable, and we want all the flavors to be in the right place. And we want it to sort of finish pleasantly and feel great in your mouth.
To Edward, to Society. You got it.
Whether you wait in line for 10 minutes or 2 hours, the maximum number of fills is 5 2-liter growlers. And you can only fill a growler so fast, so when everyone shows up with 5, it often creates a bottleneck at the taps.
It can be very, very stressful, and I feel like a lot of people, actually I know that a lot of people don't understand that, and that's why when someone looks at me and sort of, compliments that we're doing our best, and they understand the circumstance, and I see patience and kindness in their face, it actually makes me smile.
And once the growlers are filled, everyone seems to have an ear-to-ear smile because of their Hill Farmstead experience.
Chug-a-lug, chug-a-lug. So far on our trip, our favorite beer. So, and I think it's gonna stay the favorite beer.
I mean, it's totally unique. There's nothing else like this anywhere. The popularity has surged in the past couple years, and they still remain such a humble enterprise.
Once you turn someone onto it, they have to make the trip themselves. And that's kind of part of the experience too, is making the trip and knowing that you can't just go out to the 7-Eleven and buy a six pack of this stuff. I mean, it's a little bit a part of the adventure, so I really like it.
You have to come out here for the beer, for the people. I mean, I haven't met such nice people. You just gotta try it once.